final thoughts, Jack, and my takeaway from Gerrit Cole and meeting him is that I'm going to put on my producer's cap, right? The future Yankeeography Gerrit Cole, only on Yes, by the way. It's going to start with him as that 11-year-old holding that sign. Midway through, it'll be him signing with the Yankees and holding that sign up at his press conference, which was a great moment, his first Yankee moment, if you will. And then it'll wrap up with him and a pile of guys celebrating, what, one, two, three championships?
I think there are a lot of Yankee fans watching us right now who are saying, yes, make Bob Lorenz a producer, because that's exactly what they want to see happen. You're calling it a sign. For the purposes of my final point, I'm going to call it a banner, because today was a banner day for the Yankees. From Cole taking out that banner or that sign and showing how much he wanted to be a Yankee from the time he was a kid to this point, Bob, him talking about not just winning World Series title number 28 or 29, he said, let's take it to 30. So he's talking about in a 9-year marriage with the Yankees, he's hoping for multiple championships. For that to happen, Gerrit Cole has to be the pitcher that he was last year for the Houston Astros. He has to continue to dominate. The Yankees believe that he can.
Well, as of today, the sky is the limit for Gerrit Cole and the Yankees. Let's get it over to Meredith and Michael for their final thoughts, guys.
Well, thanks a lot, guys. I'll tell you what, I've been at a lot of these press conferences, and if you could get a win from a press conference, the Yankees got one and Gerrit Cole got one. He was so impressive in everything he did. You guys have already spoken about the sign, but the thing that stood out to me that he took the time to mention Marvin Miller and Curt Flood. So he has a great appreciation of those that have come before him. Obviously, he knows the Yankee organization very well, their history as well, and the Yankees did all the right things. Sure, they had to pay him a lot of money, but this is a perfect signing for them. This could be the thing that puts them over the top, and I thought he handled himself with grace and elegance, and boy, if the Yankees could have scripted this any better, I don't know how they could have.
He couldn't have done a better job up there, and I go back to something that Brian Cashman said. He was actually getting a little bit emotional when he was finally able to put that jersey on. This certainly means something to him. Wearing pinstripes and playing in the Bronx means something to him and his family, and you look at the fact, 9 years, $324 million, that's an awful large commitment, but everyone in that Yankees organization will tell you they believe in Gerrit Cole, the person he is, the pitcher he is, and they believe the best things are yet to come from him. So it's going to be an interesting thing to see a lot of firsts coming about in spring training, his first time going out there on the mound. There's going to be a lot of attention on him, but he seems like a guy that really relishes in that pressure, in that attention.
I'll tell you what, I don't think he's going to be flustered. Just from watching him today, I think he'll handle the pressure of New York, the spotlight of being on Broadway. I think he'll handle it well.
I think you're right, Michael, and I think fans are extremely excited to see him take the mound with 45 on his back and be a member of this team. They're now hoping it yields a couple of championships.
Well, it all starts in Tampa in the middle of February, but today was a good start for the Yankees. They get the number one starter on the market, one of the best pitchers in baseball, Gerrit Cole, a press conference here at the Legends Club at Yankee Stadium. He handled it well. If he handles the mound any better than this, then the Yankees have signed themselves quite a gem. Still